First thing he knew that there was nothing like Quran in the inscriptions of the pre-Muslim dynasty of Iran or the Shi'i inscriptions of 3rd century AD. Quran or Quran was a part of what is now Baluchistan, Eastern Baluchistan, the Borali Valley. In the Arab, early Arab geographical analogs and in the famous Chachnama of 9th century, it is the Borali Valley of Eastern Baluchistan, which is Quran. By huge historical misunderstanding, Quran is transferred to Central Asia. And as is well known under talking of Rustam's time, Firdausi reconstructs an imaginary empire of Quran, in which Afrasiyab is trying to conquer Iran, in fact conquer the whole world, as Sarab is said to say, Jahara Sarasar Chikushko Jahab Taranam Bafarmani Afrasiyab. Afrasiyab is the ruler of Quran. I am trying to bring whether land or sea, every land under the sovereignty of Quran. So Iran against Quran, Rustam against Quran. Agar Jul Bakaam in Manaya Jawab, the famous couplet, Mano Gurzo Maidan of Afrasiyab. That is the main, Quran is the main enemy. So Iranian patriotism is now substantive. Quran is the land of Turks. Again a misunderstanding, the Turks arrived in Central Asia only in the 5th century. They never existed earlier in the 5th century AD. It says 5th and 6th century AD, they never existed earlier. Their language is very recent. Whatever the misunderstanding, Iran is now a primitive nation and Quran is the opponent. The second opponent are Arabs. You know the famous couplet attributed to a defeated general, the Iranian general. The Shire Shutar Fuldanus Usmar, Arabra Bajai Rasid Askar, the Tahte Kayara Kunandar Du, the Fugar Duacha, the Gadda Tufu. Well, most of you would have understood it, but let me say that it means that look at Arabs, drinkers of camel's milk and eaters of lizards. They have now the guts to claim the throne, the ancient throne of Iran, Imperial Iran, following the ever-revolving fate. So the Arab, there are the two countries, the two regions which are the opponents of Iran, the Turks of Turan and Arabia. And it is in this form that patriotism, primitive patriotism also grows. You compare your country with others. You make other countries hostile to your interests. This is exactly what Shah Nama's major message is, if there is any political message within Shah Nama. For instance, in Quran he makes it clear that Quran is the country of the Turks. For instance, of Afrasiyab's princesses, princesses of Afrasiyab's family, he says, Umat of the Turkan e Koshida Ruhe. They are Turks. So the Turks are your enemy. The Arabs, of course, are already hostile. And Iran, it is the great culture of Iran and the empire of Iran that is to be upheld. Now, this is clearly a secular message. It's the Shahnama is a great point of departure from the entire religious literature of previous times. It had its predecessors, I don't dispute that, but it is Firdausi who in this enormous book puts the start, the beginning of secular poetry in Persian. When started, and once you begin to ask questions, and as my father said, you ask those questions in poetry and answer in poetry, because if you do it in prose, as perhaps you will do in Pakistan today, you will get you will be tied for blasphemy. So, better to put all these words in word, and then you could get away with it saying that I didn't mean this, I meant that. Now, many of these critical verses, critical of the existing social practices, our consolidated in the 13th and 14th century in the name of Umar Khayyam. Many studies of Umar Khayyam, the compilation of the rubaiyats or double couplets have been made. And I will not go into it, they are very well known. And Brown also recognizes that Fitzgerald's translation is by and large literal. Something like 40% of his translated verses were found to be literal translations, and others not. In these verses, there is the celebration of the tavern, the alehouse, the celebration of liquor, the celebration of worldly love, love of women, which is denounced by Orthodox. But there are further reflections. Umar Khayyam Rubaiyat, in a sense, gave made a further break. Ferdowsi is secular, Rubaiyat are critical of the entire aspect of Orthodoxy. I will just read one Persian verse, because most of us get Umar Khayyam from Fitzgerald's translation, and I found from it cursory reading of the collections of the Persian collections of Umar Khayyam's verses that Fitzgerald's representation is by and large accurate. But I read the Persian verse, Jame Mutafikaran Dar Mazhabu Deen, Jame Mutahayyaran Dar Shagu Yaqeen, ناگاہ منالی پر آیت سے کمین اے بے خبراں راہ راہ نہ آنس تو نہیں. Some people are all involved in religion and faith. Others are in doubt whether they should believe or not. But then suddenly a voice comes from the unknown. Fools, you are neither this nor that is correct. Religion and faith are as incorrect as doubt and disbelief. This is the plain meaning of the verse. And how Fitzgerald does it, the second minister, emerge from the door of darkness cries, fools, your reward is neither here nor there. This sums up Umar Khayyam. Now you can say that this is marifat or sufi, but I will go by the actual words. The actual words throughout Rubaiyat are of dissent, of doubt, of condemnation, of what was the Orthodox belief. Yeah. A glorification of alehouse, a glorification of worldly love, a rejection of the hereafter. In between stands Sadi. Sadi is, of course, as you know, an Orthodox poet. He could be very bad, he could be racialist, color conscious, anti-woman, anti-feminine, and he could also be sublime. He could say, Bani Adam as I Yagdi Garam. Human beings are the organs of Bani Chala. And he goes on to say, if one organ feels pain, if a man, a person feels pain in one organ, all his organs are troubled. So should we not feel, if one of us is troubled, should not let that troubled by us? So Bani Adam as I Yagdi Garam. Now when the United Nations wanted a principle like this to be put on the Mr. President would know much better about it than I do. Then they searched and searched for a legal modern statement, but there is no egalitarian statement like this in pre-modern literature. Only Sadi is there. And when Ram Mohan Roy, in a memorandum in 1831, some 190 years ago, was trying to prove to the British Parliament that the Bengal peasants should get some relief from the oppressive zamindars, they wanted to think, because the oppressive zamindars were Hindus and the peasants were Muslims. So not only more of Sanskrit literature than Ram Mohan Roy, but everybody also knew, perhaps very few knew, more of Persian literature than Ram Mohan Roy. And so the only verse he could get to support him was from Sadi. Ba-ra-yat sulhkun var-jang khasm ayman nashin zant shahin shahe adil ra-ra-yat lashkar hasm. If the king, if the sovereign keeps the peasant satisfied, he does not need an army to protect him from someone else. So, Sadi has said something which you cannot really find in world literature. You could